Hello everyone, this is Taylor, and today, walking through question 3 of the MAS1 Spring 2019 exam. Let's get started. You are given the following information. 1. Accidents follow a compound Poisson process. 2. Accidents occur at the rate of lambda equals 40 events per day. 3. Accident severity follows an exponential distribution with theta equal to 1,000. 4. The insurance payments for each accident is subjected to a deductible. 5. V subscript 1 is the variance of daily aggregate payments with a deductible of 100 per accident. And 6. V subscript 2 is the variance of daily aggregate payments with a deductible of 500 per accident. Calculate the ratio of V subscript 2 divided by V subscript 1. Alright, that is a mouthful. So, starting off, as I like to do, with required knowledge. So, again, this is information that I would put on my, like, study cheat sheet. So I like to go through all these questions and say, based off of this question, what would I add to my study slash cheat sheet? This variance equation is absolutely something you need. I think this appears multiple times on every past MAS1 exam, so you need to know this formula, and that is that the variance of a frequency severity model, when you have those two separate components, and when you're dealing with Tweety, you know, you have that gamma Poisson. There's like a shortcut equation, I think, for Tweety. But if you know this formula, then that's sufficient to make those calculations. And that formula is just laid out there. Second, I feel like this is a bullet point and will be for 50% of these questions, which is exponential is memoryless. And then finally, this isn't something you need to know because you can kind of derive this from the formula sheet, but the variance equals the mean for the Poisson process. So this is, I feel like for Poisson and exponential, they show up so much, just like they did in exam P. You really should know these two distributions as well as you can. So this is a worthwhile shortcut, maybe having memorized. So moving into the calculations, for the frequency, you actually need to consider the severity, and that's because of the deductible. So we know that things occur for the mean frequency, 40 events per day, right here. But we need to multiply that by the probability that one of those given claims is also larger than the deductible. Because if a claim does not reach or get past that deductible, then we're not going to see it. And so first we need to say, what is the probability that a given event will have a claim amount larger than the deductible? So that's just going to be 1 minus the CDF of an exponential distribution with theta equal to 1,000, and we're going to plug in x equal to 100. And that gets us this 90% number. So with that, we know that for deductible equals 100, the average frequency is going to be 36 claims. And then, again, taking that shortcut equation, we know that the variance is also 36. Next, we do the exact same thing, but where the deductible is 500. So when we do that, we get 0.6 or 60%, and that results in an expected average claim frequency of 24 claims. Finally, we can get to that severity component, and with that we're just looking at the exponential distribution. So the mean is going to be theta, which is just 1,000, and then the variance is going to be theta squared, so 1,000 squared. With that, we have all the components we need to plug and chug. So again, the variance of this compound distribution is just going to be the expected value of the frequency times the variance of the severity plus the mean of the severity squared times the variance of the frequency. And when you plug all those values in, this is what you get. And this first 1,000, the variance of the severity just is 1,000 squared, whereas the second, or the the right side is going to be the mean of the severity is just 1,000, but then that quantity squared is going to be 1,000 squared. So actually it's just a bunch of 1,000 squareds. Finally, you have this unnecessary calculation they build into the problem, which is V subscript 500 divided by V subscript 100. And when you do that, you notice there's just a ton of 1,000 squareds that can cancel out, and you can simplify to just 24 divided by 36. Because the 1,000 squareds cancel out, and then, you know, it's 2 times this quantity and 2 times that quantity. So 2 times 24 divided by 2 times 36, the 2's cancel as well. So it all boils down to just those two numbers, and then you finally get that resulting number of 0.67. So going up to the options, 0.67 falls between 0.6 and 0.7, so our final answer is C. So that completes today's walkthrough of question 3 for the Spring 2019 MAS1 exam. Thank you for watching, and please consider subscribing if you find these videos helpful. Have a good one. Thanks.